Welcome to Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Subject Applied Thermal Engineering, Unit 3, Steam Nozzle, Session 4, for 5th Semester Diploma in Mechanical Engineering student. Now, we will discuss a simple problem. The given problem is, a convergent divergent nozzle is required to discharge 350 kg of steam per hour. The nozzle is supplied with a steam at 8.5 bar and 90% of dry and discharge against a back pressure of 0.4 bar. Neglect the effect of friction. Find the throat and exit diameter. Now, the note down the given values. There is a mass of steam which is discharged through the nozzle per hour is 350 kg per hour. So that is converted into kg per second. That is 350 divided by 3600, that is 60 into 60, 3600. So which is equal to 0.0972 kg per second. So per second, so this much of steam is discharging. Now, the initial pressure, the given initial pressure is 8.5 bar and the dryness fraction, which is 90%, which is 0.9, or the back pressure is 0.4 bar. So these are the values given. Now, we know that from the critical pressure ratio when it is a wet steam, we know the formula when P2 by P1. We know the formula P2 by P1 is equal to 0.582. Now you substitute the value of the P1, that is the initial pressure is given. So therefore P2 is equal to 0.582 into P1. Cross multiplication, it goes to numerator. Now the P1 value is 8.5. Now multiply with 8.5 into 0.582, you will get the 4.947 bar, so which is equal to 5 bar. So P2 value is, which is equivalent to a 5 bar. Now from the steam table, corresponding to a pressure of the 5 bar, which is actually the P2 is 4.947 or 5 bar, which is you refer corresponding to a pressure of 5 bar, you will get the VG2. The pressure table corresponding to a pressure of 5 bar. So here is the 5 bar and note down the value of VG2. So it is VG2 for the 0.37466. So this is the value VG2. Now for the value of the back pressure is given 0.4 bar. That is when it is a 0.4 bar, VG3 is 3.993. So this is from the steam table, you note down. This is also from the steam table. Note down the value of VG3, that is when the back pressure is 0.4. So here is the 0.4 bar and the corresponding value of VG3 is 3.993. So this is the value of VG3. So from the steam table, now you find the value of H1, H2, H3. So how to find the value of H1, H2, H3 from the molar chart? So from the HS diagram or the molar chart, so we know the value of the P1 is 8.5 bar. So this is the pressure is 8.5 bar. That is P1 value is 8.5 bar. And so where this pressure line meets the dryness fraction 0.9, this 0.9 and the 8.5 bar, these two lines. So these two lines, this line and this line. So where these two lines are intersect, where these two lines are meet, that is the point is 1. So this is the point is 1. So here 1 is your H1. Just you extend it towards, just you draw the vertical line towards down. So when it reaches the, when it cuts the P2 pressure line, P2 value is 5 bar or 4.947, which is equal to 5 bar. Just to extend till which meet the line of 5 bar. So this is the point of 2. The point of 2, and this is the value of H2. So from the 2, from the point 2, extend till down, which meets the 0.4 bar. So when it meets the point is your third one. So that is the H3. Now H1, H2, H3. Note down the value. From the HS diagram, you will get the H1 is 2570 kilojoules per kg. Similarly, H2 value, this is the H2 value. From the HS diagram, 2480 kilojoules per kg. And also find the value of dryness fraction at the pressure of P2, this one. So this is your X21. That is dryness fraction at the throat 0.87. And X3, when it is a back pressure, so 0.777. So when it is a S3 is 2110 kilojoules per kg, and dryness fraction is X3 is 0.777. So this is the X3 value. Now X1, X2, X3. So these are the dryness fractions. Now we know the formula when it is heat drop at the throat, HD2 is equal to H1 minus H2. So this is the formula for calculating the heat drop at throat. We know the value of H1. H1 is 2570. Then minus H2 is 2480. So make it difference, you will get the 90 kilojoules per kg. So this is the HD2. So similarly, you find the velocity at throat. So this is the formula for calculating the velocity at throat is 44.72 root of HD2. So this is equal to 44.72. HD2 is, it is 90. And make it calculation of this. After calculation of this, you will get the 424.25 meter per second. Similarly, you calculate the heat drop at exit. Similarly, you calculate the heat drop at exit. HD3 is equal to H1 minus H3, where H1 is 2570 minus H3 is 2110. So difference of this, you will get the 460 kilojoules per kg. So this is the value of HD3. Now velocity at exit, V3 is equal to 44.72 root of HD3. So which is equal to, just you substitute HD3, value is 460 here. So after calculation of this, you will get the 959.14 meter per second. So this is the velocity at the exit. Now we want to find the diameters of both the exit and throat one. So first you have to calculate the throat area, then diameter. So this is the mass of steam flowing through the throat. We know the formula, M is equal to A2 V2 divided by X2 and VG2. Now you take the cross multiplication, you want to calculate A2. A2 is equal to M into X2 VG2 divided by V2. So this goes to numerator and this is goes to denominator V2. So therefore A2 is equal to, substitute the value of M. We know M is 0.0972. X2 is, when it is the 0.87. And VG2 is from the steam table, when we are referring corresponding to a pressure of 5 bar, you will get the 0.3746 divided by V2 is 424.25. So after calculation of this, you will get the 7.466 into 10 to the power of 5, which is in meters per. This is the value of area at the throat. Now you calculate the diameter. So in the given problem, you want, in the given problem, find the both the throat diameter and exit diameter. So this is for the area. Once if you know the area, now you calculate the diameter. So diameter, how to calculate the diameter? We know the area is nothing but pi by 4 into d square. Therefore, we want to calculate d2, the diameter throat d2 is equal to, this is equal to, therefore this goes to 4 into this value, that is 7.466 into 10 to the power of 5 into 4 divided by this pi. So after calculation of this, you will get the, so we are taking the just the d2 is equal to this, a square root. Now therefore d2 is equal to square root of this value. So after the calculation, you will get the d2 is equal to 9.75 mm. So this is the diameter of the throat is 9.75 mm. Now similarly, you calculate the area at the exit and then diameter. First you calculate the area. We know similarly, similar procedure you have to repeat. We know the formula M is equal to A3 V3 divided by X3 VG3. Therefore, area is equal to M into X3 into VG3 divided by V3. So, we know the value of M, that is 0.972 X3 from the HS diagram. You have to consider X3 value, that is dryness fraction 0.777 into, this is the VG3 from the steam table corresponding to a pressure. We know that 3.993 divided by V3 is velocity at the exit. V3 is 959.14. This is equal to, so after calculation of this, you will get the 3.144 into 10 to the power of 4 minus 4. 3.144 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Is in meter square. So we want to calculate the diameter. Therefore, the area at the exit is A3 is equal to pi by 4 into A3 square. Therefore, D3 is equal to the square root of, is the square root we are removing, that is square root of this. This is equal to 20 mm. So this is the diameter is the exit of the nozzle is 20 mm. The exit of the nozzle is 20 mm. The throat diameter is 9.75 mm and exit diameter of the nozzle is 20 mm. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.